Hello everyone, welcome to the second lecture of the series Operating System. Today we discuss about types of operating system. Myself Mohushumi Shaha, Assistant Professor of Computer Science and Engineering Department, Narula Institute of Technology. The main objective of operating system is the operating system act as a resource allocator and it act as a control programmer. The operating system manages all the resources and allocate the resources to the corresponding jobs. The operating system also control the execution of user program and operations of IO devices. Operating system are there from the very first computer generation and they keep evolving with time. In this chapter, we will discuss some of the important types of operating system which are most commonly used. The first one is batch processing. The user of a batch operating system do not interact with the computer directly. Each user prepare his job on an offline device like punch card and submit it to the computer operator. To speed up processing, jobs with similar needs are batched together and run as a group. The programmer leaves the program with the operator and the operator then short the program with similar requirement into batches. The problem with batch systems are lack of interaction between the user and the job. In batch processing system, CPU is often idle because of the speed of the mechanical input output device is slower than the CPU and it's difficult to provide the desired priority. So batch processing is a technique in which an operating system collects the programs and the data together in a batch before processing starts. An operating system does the following activity related to batch processing. The operating system defines a job which has predefined sequence of commands, program, and data as a single unit. The OS keep a number of job in memory and execute them without any manual information. Jobs are processed in order of the submission, that is in first come first serve fashion. When a job completes its execution, its memory is released and the output for the job gets copied into the output pool for later printing or processing. So the advantages of batch processing system is batch processing takes much of the work of the operator to the computer. And another advantage is it increases the performance as a new job gets started as soon as the previous job is finished without any manual intervention. And the disadvantage of batch processing is it is difficult to debug the program. A job could enter in an infinite loop. Due to lack of protection scheme, one bad job can affect pending jobs. In this execution environment, CPU is often idle because of the speed of the mechanical input-output device. It is slower than the electronic device CPU. In order to overcome the problem of speed mismatch, the concept of spooling is introduced. So in mainframe computer, what is spooling? Spooling, the acronym of spooling stands for Simultaneous Peripheral Operation Online. Spooling was one of the earliest multiprogramming application. Jobs are read via a card reader and copied into a disk file. The operating system reads the file. Printable output generated by the running program is written to another disk file. While printing a program constantly print the data in this file. Another benefit of spooling is that access to the slow peripheral is restricted to a program named spool print program. The next is multiprogramming system. Sharing the processor when two or more program resides in main memory at the same time. It referred as multiprogramming. Multiprogramming assumes a single shared processor. Multiprogramming increases the CPU utilization by organizing the job so that the CPU is always has one job to execute. The advantages of multiprogramming is high and efficient CPU utilization. The user feels that many programs are allocated CPU almost simultaneously. And the disadvantage of multiprogramming is CPU scheduling is required. To accommodate many jobs in memory, memory management is also required. The next type of operating system is multitasking operating system. Multitasking is when multiple jobs are executed by the CPU simultaneously by switching between them. Switching occurs so frequently that the user may interact with each other while it's running. An operating system does following activities related to multitasking. The user gives instruction to the operating system or to a program directly and receive an immediate response. The operating system handles multitasking in the way that it can handle multiple operations, multiple program at a time. Multitasking operating system is also known as time sharing system. This operating system were developed to provide interactive use of computer system at a reasonable cost. A time-shared operating system uses the concept of CPU scheduling and multiprogramming to provide each user with a small portion of time-shared CPU. A program is loaded into the main memory and it executing is commonly referred as program. When a process is executed, it typically execute only a short of time before it either finish or need to perform an input-output. Since interactive input-output typically runs at slower speed, it may take long time to complete. During this time, the CPU can be utilized by another process. The next one is parallel system. The parallel operating system are used to interact multiple network computer to complete tasks in parallel. The architecture of software is often a Unix-based platform which allow it to coordinate distributed load between the multiple computer in a network. The parallel operating system are able to use the software that manages all the different resources of the computer running in parallel, such as memory, cache, storage space, and processing power. Parallel operating system also allow the user to directly interface between all the computer in the network. So the advantage of parallel systems are increased throughput, it is economical, and increased reliability. The next one is distributed system. This type of operating system is recent advancement in the world of computer technology, are being widely acceptable all over the world, that too with a great pace. Various autonomous interconnection computer communicate with each other using a shared communication network. Independent system possess their own memory unit and CPU. These are referred as loosely coupled system or distributed system. This system processor differ in size and function. The major benefit of working with this type of operating system is that it is always possible that one user can access the file or software which are not actually present on his system, but on some other system connected with the same network. So remote access is enabled within the device connected to the network. The advantages of distributed system are resource sharing, computational speed up and load sharing. It is reliable and communication. The next type of operating system is known as network operating system. This system run on a server and provide capable to manage data, user group, security applications and other network functions. This type of operating system allow shared access of file, printer, security applications and other networking. Functions over a small private network, one or more aspect of network operating system is that all the users are well aware of the underlying configuration. Of all other users within the network, they are individual connections. And that's why these computers are popularly known as tightly coupled system. Next one is real-time operating system. The primary objective of real-time operating system is to provide quick response time and thus the meet a scheduled deadline. User convenience and resource utilization are secondary concerns of this system. Real-time operating system has many events that must be accepted and processed in a short time or within a certain deadline. Such applications include rocket launching, flight control, robotics, real-time simulation, telephone switching equipment, etc. So real-time operating systems are classified into two categories. One is hard real-time system, second one is soft real-time system. The soft real-time system happen when a certain deadline are missed, then system continue its working without no failure, but its performance degrades. It is a less restrictive type of real-time system where a critical real-time task gets priority over the task and retain the priority until it's complete. Soft real-time system have more limited utility than hard real-time system. And second one is hard real-time system. If any deadline is missed, then the system will fail to work or does not work properly. This system guarantees that critical tasks be completed on time. Virtual memory is never found in a real-time system. So, hard real-time system conflict with the operation of time-sharing system. And the two cannot be mixed. Since more of the existing general-purpose operating systems support hard real-time functionality. So, thank you for today. We will discuss our next topic very soon. If you have any query, feel free to contact me. This is my mail ID. Thank you all.